Our Mass presider is Father Tito Caluag. Entrance Antiphon. You will receive the power of the Holy Spirit coming upon you, and you will be my witnesses, even to the ends of the earth. Alleluia.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, to prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries, let us call to mind our sins and ask the Lord for pardon and strength. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
And let us pray. May the power of the Holy Spirit come to us, we pray, O Lord, that we may keep your will faithfully in mind and express it in a devout way of life. Our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. While Apollos was in Corinth, Paul traveled through the interior of the country and down to Ephesus, where he found some disciples. He said to them, "Did you receive the Holy Spirit when you became believers?" They answered him, "We have never even heard that there is a Holy Spirit." He said, "How were you baptized?" They replied, "With the baptism of John." Paul then said, "John baptized with the baptism of repentance, telling the people to believe in the one who was to come after him, that is, in Jesus." When they heard this, they were baptized in the name of the Lord Jesus. And when Paul laid his hands on them, the Holy Spirit came upon them, and they spoke in tongues and prophesied. Altogether, there were about 12 men. He entered the synagogue, and for 3 months debated boldly with persuasive arguments about the kingdom of God, the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Responsorial Psalm. Sing to God, O kingdoms of the earth.
Sing to God, O kingdoms of the earth.
God arises, his enemies are scattered, and those who hate him flee before him. As smoke is driven away, so are they driven, as wax melts before the fire.
Sing to God, O kingdoms of the earth.
But the just rejoice and exult before God. They are glad and rejoice. Sing to God, chant praise to his name, whose name is the Lord.
Sing to God, O kingdoms of the earth.
The father of orphans and the defender of widows is God in his holy dwelling. God gives a home to the forsaken. He leads forth prisoners to prosperity.
Sing to God, O kingdoms of the earth. Alleluia, alleluia. If then you were raised with Christ, seek what is above, where Christ is seated at the right hand of God. Alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A proclamation of the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, Lord.
The disciples said to Jesus, "Now you are talking plainly and not in any figure of speech. Now we realize that you know everything and that you do not need to have anyone question you. Because of this, we believe that you came from God." Jesus answered them, "Do you believe now? Behold, the hour is coming and has arrived when each of you will be scattered to his own home, and you will leave me alone. But I am not alone because the Father is with me. I have told you this so that you might have peace in me. In the world, you will have trouble, but take courage, I have conquered the world." My dear brothers and sisters, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Today, as we begin this week, no, let me just sort of give the arc of this week, no, yung arko ng ating pagninilay ngayong linggon to, no. So ito na yung huling bahagi ng 16th chapter of St. John. No? And then we begin to read the Gospel from the 17th chapter of John. No? And yung chapter 17, napakaganda nung kanyang discourse doon kasi sa darating na Webes, magka-climax yung chapter 17 by that beautiful prayer of consecration to the people who will, that the Lord is sending out into the world, no, in order to continue His mission, which is of course na pagnilaya natin kahapon yan sa kapistahan ng Ascension, tapos sa darating na linggo ay Pentecost. So mahalagang malagay natin sa framework na yon ang pagninilay natin ngayong linggo, because I think it's one of those periods in Easter, the seventh week of Easter, that I think has to be taken as a whole, no, from the Ascension and then the gospel readings for this coming week, and then the Pentecost, no, to prepare us to go. It's almost like to go out into the world come ordinary time, no, the day after Pentecost. So siguro yun ang ating laging isaisip ngayong linggon to, no, na nagsimula tayo ng linggo, Ascension Sunday, yung pag-akyat ng Panginoon sa langit, ano, at ang paghahabilin niya ng mission natin bilang simbahan na ipagpatuloy ang kanyang mission. At ito naman, magka-climax ang linggo sa darating na Pentecost Sunday, na ating pagninilayan ang pagluklok ng Espiritu Santo, no, ang pagsukob ng Espiritu Santo sa atin, no, the coming of the Spirit to us as church, no. So I think it's important that we look at it that way, no. Isang kabuuan yung ating pagninilay ngayong linggo. Siguro lang narinig natin ngayon sa Ebanghelyo na it is the last chapter, last section of chapter 16. And then the Lord now will, sabi ko nga, pagdadasal niya na yung mga apostolis niya. Tapos sa Biyernes naman at sa Sabado, babasahin natin yung kahuli-hulihang resurrection appearance sa Ebanghelyo ni San Juan. Yung pagtatalaga, no, kay San Pedro bilang pinuno ng simbahan, na napakagandang, one of my favorites actually. So I hope you will look forward to the reflections this coming week, which will reach its in a sense, no, its synthesis, if you wish, no, in the final appearance of the risen Lord, and then Pentecost na tayo. So for today, no, I want you to sort of read the gospel again. This is chapter 16, 29 to verses 29 to 33. The Lord now finally says, no, that okay, I am about to die on the cross, the glory of the cross. He was already talking about the cross, no. And he was predicting that I will be alone, no. Remember, one of the most beautiful descriptions of Christ on the cross was that at that moment of death on the cross, during his suffering and death on the cross, one theologian said that was the radical solitude of Christ with his Father. And that was what, in a sense, no, a major part in winning for us our salvation, that radical solitude with the Father on the cross. And the Lord is talking about that now. Sinabi na niya, di ba, na dadating ang araw, a few days from this last discourse, actually the following day, that you will leave me alone. And yet I am not alone, because the Father is always in me and I am always in the Father. Lagi kong kapiling ang Ama. At yun ang kanyang, kumbaga, ay pagpapahiwatig na yung triumph niya sa krus. Yung kanyang pagkapanalo, no? Laban sa kasamaan, laban sa kasamaan ng mundong ito, laban sa kasalanan at laban sa kamatayan. So the Lord clearly declares that already, no, that it is now that moment. It is really a moment of glory, no. That's why if you listen to what the apostle says, now you are talking plainly and not in any figure of speech. Kumbaga, tahasan mo na sinabi sa amin. You told us very clearly and openly, no. And I think this is something that again prepares us, no, for the prayer of consecration that will be developed these coming days, no. So maybe I just want to invite you as we begin this final week of reflection, no, during this final days of Easter, to spend time again reflecting in terms of ano nga ba yung aking talagang paninindigan sa aking pagsunod sa Panginoon? What is my commitment now in following Christ? Because remember, since last week, I've been encouraging all of us to reflect once more on our mission. And here, the Lord is saying clearly, no, na magmumula yung mission na yon sa kanyang tagumpay sa krus at tagumpay sa muling pagkabuhay. That it is the victory of the cross and resurrection now that will mark the mission of the church, that will mark our own mission. At ito yung kanyang hinabilin, di ba, sa atin. At ito yung biyaya na dapat natin ipagpatuloy sa ating sariling buhay ngayon. Of course, sa simbahan, sa early church, at ngayon sa ating sariling simbahan ngayon. So today, I invite all of you, as we begin this week, let us make this really a week of prayer. And again, a week of prayer to understand, di ba? But the Lord is finally saying, as He leaves us, so to speak, and sends us out into the world. And let me just read again the ending of today's gospel. No? I have told you this so that you might have peace in me. In the world, you will have trouble. But take courage, I have conquered the world. And let that be the introduction of our prayer and reflection this week. The very last lines of today's gospel. No? Na sinabi ko sa inyo ito upang merong kayong kapayapaan sa akin. At sa mundo, mahaharapin ninyo ang mga suliranin. Pero huwag kayong matakot. Maging matatag kayo sapagkat nadaig ko na ang mundo. And let us pray that we will have that courage as we go out into the world and to build the kingdom of God. Let us draw courage and strength and hope from these words of the Lord. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Amen.
In His farewell discourse to His disciples, the Lord tells them to have peace in Him because by His death and resurrection, He will conquer the world with its fears and meaninglessness. And so with confidence we pray, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us not be overly worried about what we are to eat, to drink, or to wear, but trust in our Creator who provides even for the birds of the air and the lilies of the field. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Deliver us from useless anxiety by entrusting the future in the hands of God. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Save us from the power of the devil, the ancient enemy. For Jesus has conquered the prince of this world, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us not fear those who kill the body, but rather fear the Lord who has the power to destroy both body and soul, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Deliver us from the torment of death and the dread of perpetual extinction, for we are made for communion with God, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And together we will pray the prayer for the 2022 elections, after which we'll also pray the memorare. This whole month of May, we will pray the memorare after the prayer to the elections. And the memorare is in union with the church and the call of the Pope to pray to our Blessed Mother to intercede to put an end to the pandemic. Prayer for the elections. God our Father, as we prepare for our 2022 elections, we put our trust in your promise that you will send us leaders after your own heart and spirit. Lord Jesus, inspire all who seek office to be servant leaders who will put the greater good of the greater majority, especially the poor, the marginalized, and the vulnerable, above any personal or group interests. Servant leaders who will seek office to genuinely serve and not to be served. Servant leaders of integrity and compassion, Holy Spirit, enlighten our minds and hearts that we may see clearly the needs of our people and what candidates promise and their ability to fulfill these, that we choose rightly the leaders who will truly lead and serve, leaders after your own heart and spirit, leaders who will unite and lead us to do what is for the greater good of the greater majority, and what is for your greater glory. Father, Son, and Spirit, you are the God of life and love, the Lord of history. Be with us in this time of preparation for the coming elections. Amen. Our Lady of Fatima,
pray for us.
Our Lady of the Immaculate Conception, Patroness of the Philippines,
pray for us.
The Memorare. Remember, O most gracious Virgin Mary, that never was it known that anyone who fled to thy protection, implored thy help, or sought thy intercession was left unaided. Inspired with this confidence, we turn to thee, O Virgin of Virgins, our Mother. To thee we come, before thee we stand, sinful and sorrowful. O Mother of the Word incarnate, despise not our petitions, but in thy mercy hear and answer us. Amen. Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation. To your goodness we have this bread and this wine to offer. Fruit of the earth, fruit of the vine, and work of human hands, they will become for us our spiritual food, our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that this, our sacrifice, may be made acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy Church.
May this unblemished sacrifice purify us, O God, and impart to our minds the force of grace from on high, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For the Lord Jesus, the King of glory, conqueror of sin and death, ascended to the highest heavens as the angels gazed in wonder. Mediator between God and man, judge of the world and Lord of hosts, he ascended not to distance himself from our lowly state, but that we, his members, might be confident of following where he, our head and founder, has gone before. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise. And even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the night that he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, he gave you thanks. He broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Again, he gave you thanks and praise. He gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant. It will be shed for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, this life-giving bread, this saving cup. We thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your Church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Onesto, our Bishop, the clergy, the entire people your son has gained for you. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them, Lord, into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, from every evil, and grant us peace in our day. In your mercy, keep us free from sin and protect us from all anxiety, as we wait in joyful hope for the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom and the power and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, I leave you peace, my peace I give you. Lord, we beg you not to look on our sins, but on the faith of your church. And grant us the peace, the unity, and the joy of your kingdom where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And let us offer each other the sign of peace. Peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
My dear brothers and sisters, behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away our sins, the sin of the world. Happy are we who are called to share in the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
May the body and blood of Christ bring us all to everlasting life.
Amen. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
And together let us pray the Oratio Imperata.
God of mercy and compassion, we come to you in the midst of our sufferings due to the COVID-19 pandemic, and ask for your healing love to overcome our fear of sickness and death, and to restore our hope and faith. We pray for all health workers who are the frontliners in serving and healing the victims of the virus. Protect them and grant them your inspiration to sustain them in body, mind, heart, and spirit. And for those who fell ill and passed on, reward them with eternal life with you and consolation for their loved ones. For all who work tirelessly to serve the needs of the people, keep them safe too, and grant them your guidance, most especially our leaders, to selflessly work for the common good and find meaning in their service. We pray for the victims of this virus, the dying, and those who have died in agony and loneliness. Let their suffering be their participation in the suffering of your Son that redeemed us. For all who are infected, heal them and grant them full recovery. Continue to guide our experts tasked to find effective vaccines and cures for this virus. Use them as instruments in your healing hands. We ask all this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son and our divine healer, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
We fly to your protection, O Holy Mother of God. Do not despise our petition in our necessities, but deliver us always from all dangers. O glorious and ever blessed Virgin.
Amen.
Our Lady, help of all Christians and health of the sick.
Pray for us.
Our Lady of Fatima.
Pray for us.
Saint Joseph.
Pray for us.
Saint Raphael the Archangel.
Pray for us.
Saint Roch.
Pray for us.
Saint Lorenzo Ruiz.
Pray for us.
Saint Pedro Calungsod.
Pray for us.
Most Sacred Heart of Jesus.
Have mercy on us.
Santo Niño de Cebu.
Have mercy on us.
Divine Mercy.
Have mercy on us.
And let us pray. Graciously be present to your people, we pray, O Lord, and lead those you have imbued with heavenly mysteries to pass from former ways to newness of life, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless us, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass is ended. Let us go in peace to love and to serve the Lord and one another.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you, and have a good day and have a good week ahead. And again, I encourage you to read chapter 17 of the Gospel of St. John as we prepare for this final week of our Easter Masses and Reflections. Thank you.
Sa pamamagitan ng ating Alay Kapwa program, sa panahon ng kalamidad gaya ng bagyo, lindol at iba pang paghihirap sa buhay ng ating mga kapatid, ang Alay Kapwa program ng ating simbahan ay laging handang tumulong at tumugon. Kamakailan lamang po, tayo ay naglaan ng 5 million pesos para sa kindness stations or community pantries ng mga social action centers ng 50 dioceses sa Luzon, Visayas at Mindanao. Ito po ay galing sa inyong mga donations na pakunti-kunting ibinigay sa pamamagitan ng ating panawagan dito sa ABS-CBN. Kapwa ko,